smile. You've got me smiling wider than a mile.
Days are sunnier when I'm with you.
At last our happy are two.
Oh, you tickle me. You tickle me. You make me laugh, I'm happy as can be. Cause you tickle me.
Sing along!
Hello, you inanimate interneters. I'm Abby from Inanimate Public Radio, here to spill the tea with the latest eliminated contestant from Inanimate Insanity Invitational.
That's me. I'm Tea Kettle. Ask away, Abby.
All right, Tea Kettle. How are you enjoying your time on a definite island so far?
Well, I'll tell you, hon, it may look like a pretty crummy island, and that's because it is. The sky is always dark. There's barely any food around here. But luckily, I found more coconuts. Turns out they're not only indefinite, but also inconspicuous. The others here gave up, but I know where to look.
Oh, Tea Kettle, always caring for others, huh? What led to these motherly instincts kicking in?
Look, that's just a part of who I am. Yeah, I'm kind of maternal, but I don't want anyone losing sight of the fact that I came to compete. I wasn't just there to be the team's protector.
Right, I know what you mean. So, this asker wants to know, what did you think of Box getting injured?
Gee, I don't know. If someone you cared about fell down a hill and spontaneously combusted, how would you feel about it? What kind of question is that? I wish I could have protected him! You know, for the sake of the team.
I'm sorry, let's go for something that'll cheer you up. Say that really funny note that made you all laugh? We never got to see it. Do you mind telling us what was on it?
Oh, it was too funny. It was... Gosh, okay. I can't explain it. I can. But you wouldn't appreciate it. You just had to be there. I'm sorry.
I suppose it shall remain a mystery that'll haunt me for the rest of my days. Anyway, Tea Kettle, if you had to pick a baked good and only ever eat that one baked good, what would it be?
I'll tell you what it would be. It would be a very poor diet. Seriously, who's supervising your eating habits? I'd like to have a word with them.
I don't think you understand. They were just being silly.
I'll say.
So, Tea Kettle, what's your favorite type of tea?
Mine!
Love it. Now tell me, how do you make your famous hors d'oeuvres, and what is your favorite to make?
Well, I pack each and every one of my little hors d'oeuvres with love. Okay, yeah, but for real, make sure you've got plenty of garlic and chili powder. I slap that stuff on everything. Goes super well with my deviled eggs. Those are the best. Even Blueberry cracked a smile when he had one, and that's the real seal of approval if you ask me.
Ooh, that sounds delish. Fittingly enough, we received this question and I quote, Tea Kettle, can I have some of your hors d'oeuvres, please?
Well, you did say please, but you didn't say may I, so I'm feeling neutral.
So am I. Now, Tea Kettle, how do you think Nickel and Balloon will do now that they're so outnumbered? Do you think they'll still be able to find a way to turn this competition around?
Well, I wish those boys the best, for Balloon's sake. He's a sweet kid, and he was so anxious at that elimination. And hey, I'd be too if I chose to keep Nickel around. I honestly think Balloon made a huge mistake. But hey, sometimes you just gotta let your boys make mistakes and learn from experience.
You mean teammates, right?
That's what I said.
No, it wasn't. You said boys.
Like a vault. Do you talk to your mother that way? Argue with her? Eliminate her? Would you vote out your own mother?
Wow, there's a lot to unpack there. So Tea Kettle, would you say you felt underappreciated by your team?
I'll make this one real plain. Balloon kept Nickel over me. Let me say that again. He kept nickel over me. Yeah, I feel an eensy-weensy bit underappreciated. Wouldn't you?
Do you think of any contestants as close relatives?
Of course not. I'm a competitor. Don't let the motherliness fool ya. Sure, I baked my team some dishes and knishes and helped them develop some manners and watched as they grew up before my eyes before they betrayed me. Like a child moving out to live their life, leaving you alone in the dust.
If I may, it sounds like you're describing Balloon and Nickel as your own kids.
Yes, Abby, I know I'm describing them as my own kids. You don't need to spell it out.
You want to get into all of that?
Nope. I'm a competitor, Abby. Let's talk game.
Sure, of course. What would you say is your favorite memory from your time on Inanimate Insanity?
There was this one time before the volcano scaling challenge. I knew I was next to go without my ally life ring. So I prepared my greatest strength-building recipe, spinach tidbits. I knew Nickel wouldn't try them. So Balloon and I told him they were sour candies and told him how much cooler he'd be than us if he completed the sour ball challenge. And he downed a full plate all at once. I could tell he was disgusted, but I didn't hear a lick about it because he wouldn't admit that challenge was hard for him. He tried to fake this huge smile. Then we won the challenge. It was nice. We didn't get too many big victories as a family. That was my favorite. Even if, I guess, it was motherly of me.
Girl, you were a total competitor. Are you kidding? That's so great. You give people strength and you rock the contest.
Gosh, yeah. It was fun while it lasted. And I'm proud of my game. Call me a mom all you want, but I was here to play.
Right? And who wouldn't want to have a motherly figure on their side? Especially in a competition like this. You know what? To answer your earlier question, no, I could never vote out my own mother. No one's that cruel. No one.
Thank you, Abby. At least someone here gets that.